Good morning, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here. It's feels like following Richard Pryor when you follow the founder of St. Jude. So we'll try and do our best. Really happy to see everyone for the first time since JP Morgan. This is the family we choose to be around. The clicker is not clicking. 2032. Okay, there, thank you. We have, when we talk about this being a family of what we do for a living and what we choose, we want to dedicate this talk within the last 2 weeks. A colleague from my entire career had a sudden death. Gary Hume has been a colleague and a friend, and he's led the development work on this project in our partnership with Phoenix DeVentures. So there's a family we have, the family we choose, and this is certainly a pleasure to see everyone again with our commitment to really go out and save lives as a commitment and as a business. And we're gonna do that at Mitre Medical. We do a safer, simpler remodeling of the left ventricle. And when we do that, we save lives and hospitalizations. And that hospitalization is gonna be a recurring theme because that's driving reimbursement and that's driving the economics. So if you find an unmet need with strong reimbursement and the biodesign model, you end up with a sustainable business. That massive unmet need we're going after is heart failure. And in particular, that interventional leadership and treatment leadership has been led by MitraClip. The COAPT trial was fantastic. It's really made MitraClip a rocket, but there are a large number of patients that are left behind, over 800,000, that do not meet the inclusion and exclusion for the MitraClip. And we're going after that underserved patient population. There's a sort of a mapping now in the terminology for these heart failure patients where you look at the amount of leak, which is the y-axis, and the size of the ventricle on the x-axis. And there's been a shift away from saying that the most important thing is the leak to what is really important is the exhausted ventricle in the enlarged heart. And that's the patients that we go after. So our indications right now in our FDA approved trial is actually for larger hearts and harder symptomatic patients with less ventricular leak. Really fortunate to have a outstanding clinical advisory board led by Dr. Michael Mack out of Baylor Scott & White, 44 New England Journal of Medical articles on the mitral valve. We recently had our one-year data published for our European experience. We're gonna talk about that briefly. So peer-reviewed in the Journal of Cardiothoracic and Vascular Surgery. We showed that we could bring down the MR, but most importantly, we could allow the surgeons a device that sits on the outside of the heart, so no pump time, no atriotomy. They can slip it on like a slipper on the outside of the heart and reduce that ventricular size. And once again, that's driving hospitalizations. In our patient series, we had none. Now, the importance of timing's everything, right? So if you think the 5 years ago, the most important thing was to reduce the leak. The data now shows you wanna reduce the workload on the heart. And so you do that by changing that geometry. The RESTORE trial and the COAPT trial both showed clinical significance, and the number one driver for those outcomes was ventricular dimensions. The RESTORE trial showed, from the COAPTIS, showed a 10% reduction, 5% in the controls. In the COAPT trial, it was a 2% reduction in the ventricular size. Paralleled clinical outcomes. And in our series, we had 31% ventricular size. So when the bigger hearts you have, the bigger benefit we have. So that dose response is something that we really appreciate, and so does the CMS. CMS has raised the reimbursement for MitraClip to really drive heart failure patients to get treated earlier because they reduce hospitalizations. Now, we're not the first group to try and work on the outside of the heart and not do not require a bypass, or excuse me, not require open heart procedure. The annuloplasty rings from their own clinical trials have shown that it's not enough to just do the valve and restore symmetry. And if you know the ACORN trials, they showed that doing a full support of the heart for this patient population is limited. Now, there's new work you'll hear today from Coronova where they're doing bridge to recovery, where they're dynamically holding the heart, but that's a different patient population. We're right in the middle. We give you symmetry, we give you structural support, we do it on a beating heart, and we can do it in less than 15 minutes. It's well recognized that this patient is fundamentally untreated, the largest unmet needs, underserved patients in structural heart. And what we've learned, and what we've been able to do during COVID, because we had our clinical data and our US trial approved just at the start of 2020, is we've expanded this effort to really start working on the right-sided heart failure. So we also have a tricuspid project in preclinical work. So we're really opening up a toolbox of epicardial devices. The fundamentals from Ginger Graham, I heard Guyton mentioned in the last talk. I still remember when she said 50% of our top line is from recent companies, 80% of our bottom line. We have to innovate to both reduce costs to the industry and raise costs to the bottom line. So where do we go and where do we fit? Well, we can be added on to bypass procedures, which you just heard about in the last procedure. Up to 30% of them have a structural heart problem at the same time. You can take our device and slip it on atraumatically on a beating heart and look for the signature you're looking for. There is no other device that you basically get to try it before you buy it. So we have sizers that let you sit there, and the surgeons, they're just in awe because they've always wanted to remodel the heart. They know its benefit, they get to do it in their hands. And then the bigger upside is to go into heart failure as a standalone. So we've done it through many thoracotomies. We've done it in collaboration with AtriClip and Intuitive Surgical in cadaver models. Sometimes it's easier not to be the first one. You know, MitraClip named their trials Everest because of the huge burdens and obstacles in front of them, but they're reaping the rewards for that. They've evened that pathway for us, and we're actually having an FDA discussion for a registry approval pathway to get to market. The trial is an EFS that we're looking to fund. That's why we're here. Happy to talk with folks about it. It is an approved EFS study. We're at Michigan, Piedmont, Rutgers, as well as Baylor Scott & White. We're also in parallel now, the really driving innovations for these approval and regulatory paths is the fact that both the US and Japan are accelerating their access to new products while Europe is doing its own thing, shall we say. So Japan is of particular importance because the second largest cardiovascular market. They have the largest, the oldest patient population, so they have the highest heart failure population as a percentage to treat, and they specialize in off-pump surgeries. And we're an off-pump device, right? So we can eliminate that pump time, eliminate that surgeon. But in Japan, it's a particular interest. So we've been over there, we've met and collaborated with consultants, over 20 interviews. Fundamentally, they philosophically don't want to do open heart procedures. So we think of them as just being off pump. So we're more than 60% of the cases in Japan are right in our wheelhouse. They're already doing off pump, but they can't do anything to the mitral off pump without us. And then in consistent with their culture, they're also more than half of their gas stations in Japan now are also off pump, and their electrics, they're all electric. Wouldn't go into Japan on our own, wouldn't make that mistake. So we have a terrific group of scientific advisors and consultants, very experienced in Japan, so that we enter the PMDA meetings that we've had with the right company, shall we say. We're raising $6 million to get to FDA approval. This will fund our EFS trial and our entrance into our confirmatory study. And an additional $6 million would allow us to do the same in Japan. In Japan, one aspect that's of interest is We see in the US it would go into the operating room as an add-on procedure, and the next indication would be straight for heart failure, which would compete against that MitraClip patient. In Japan, they want to totally skip that step. They want to go right now, minimally invasive, the first patient's off the bat, just through the ribs, and compete against heart failure and the MitraClip for the cardiac surgeons. My name's John McMahon. We're at Mitre Medical. I look forward to speaking with you in the breakout room if anyone has any questions. Thank you.